is my heart's speech. Your mercy is what I beseech. Keep in my heart your remembrance, and in your deen allow me to advance. Help me in my quest. Permit me to pass the ultimate test. Help me in my quest. Permit me to pass the ultimate test.
Question we have tonight is from Sister Rida from Pakistan. She says, here in Pakistan, the Shi'a sect beat themselves until they are covered in blood in order to commemorate the day, the 10th day of Muharram. They also scream and shout throughout the day while they are abusing themselves. Most importantly, they curse the companions and Yazid throughout the day. First of all, Yazid was not one of the companions. Yazid is the son of Muawiyah, may Allah be pleased with him. During the era of Yazid, the son of Muawiyah, during his khilafah, horrible things have happened. Great errors and mistakes, including, of course, the murder and the killing of the grandson of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Al-Husayn, during the Battle of Karbala. And that's why, according to our predecessors, such as Al-Imam Ahmad, Imam Ahlul Sunnah wal-Jama'ah, he said when he was asked concerning Yazid, what shall we say about him? Shall we curse him? Shall we like him? He said, we neither like him nor curse him. His matter is up to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the most wise ruling, because it's up to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to pardon, to forgive, or to seize the punishment, especially when we're talking about somebody who's a Muslim. And some people say he repented or he did not. This is not our business. But cursing any of the companions is a rebellious act. And certain companions, whenever you go near them with any harm, even by the tongue, then this is an act of kufr and shirk. Because these companions who have been praised and admired by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and his most beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the only one who used to receive the revelation from Allah, he told him that Abu Bakr fil Jannah, Umar fil Jannah, Uthman fil Jannah, Ali fil Jannah, Abu Ubaid ibn al-Jarrah, Abdurrahman ibn Auf, Abdullah ibn Salam, and others, whether the 10 heavenly bound companions or others whom the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave them the glad tidings that they are in heaven. With regards to Umar ibn Khattab radiyallahu ta'ala anhu arda, there is a continuous testimony. Many ahadith confirmed that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave him the bishara that he will be amongst Ahlul Jannah. So when somebody, an ignorant person, accuses any of these companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam who have been mentioned by name by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam as they will be saved, and these ahadith has been transmitted to us or have been transmitted to us via a continuous testimony, then such person is a non-Muslim. So we have to be very careful with that. As far as the false practice of the Shia on the 10th of Muharram, I just want to tell you that, by the way, the Battle of Karbala and the death of the grandson of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Al-Husayn, on the hand of his enemies was very barbaric and a very tragic and the most heinous act in an episode in our history. Yet this event took place on the year 61 after the migration. After the migration. It happened to be on the 10th of Muharram. But the commemoration and the fasting on the 10th of Muharram was prescribed by the Prophet ﷺ upon entering Al-Madinah way before this event. So 61 years before that. So the claim that commemorate the day and we fasted because of that, this is all vain, false, and baseless. Rather, we're doing this because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Ahtasibu ala Allah." I hope and I pray that Allah will expiate the sins of the entire past years, referring obviously to the minor sins, for the person who would fast on the 10th of Muharram. So that has nothing to do with the false practices of the Shia and others who beat themselves until they bleed and they're covered with blood. These images are awful and they do not represent Islam and Muslims. As a matter of fact, they come in clear contradiction to the instructions of the Quran and the teachings of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered us to protect ourselves against any harm and those who are under our guardianship. And furthermore, he forbade us from harming ourselves by saying, وَلَا تُلْقُوا بِأَيْدِيكُمْ إِلَى التَّهْلُكَ. And we discussed before the very famous hadith in which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, لَا ضَرَرَ وَلَا ضِرَارَ. You cannot harm others. So how will you be able to harm yourself? That's not permissible. So in addition to beating themselves until they're covered with blood, they're committing a big sin, a major sin, by beating themselves, by celebrating something that is not prescribed, nor is it allowed. That has nothing to do with Islam. And I hope that we can spread the word worldwide. These guys do not represent Islam. These activities have nothing to do with the pure essence of the magnificent message of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Islam.